I find it a little difficult to say what the sub...
What's going on, guys? Metric AB is back with the version 1.4 after quite some time. Anyways, what is Metric AB? What allows you to compare A and B, the before and after of either your own track after you apply some processing or with a reference track. You can drop the reference tracks right here. For example, here I'm playing in my DAW, I'm playing the song and then I'm comparing it to before the processing, basically what we call the ref. So this is pretty cool. And you got spectrum, you can sync those two, you got dynamics, and you got loudness control. So Metric AB should live on your mix bus or your master bus, however you want to call it. Anyways, I'm gonna calm down a little bit here and talk a little bit more about why Metric AB 1.4 upgrade is a cool thing. So ADPTR, as I call it, it's actually called Adapter Audio Systems, is something that came out some years ago, a couple of years ago or so, I think in 2020, and hasn't seen a significant update since. And they've been talking about doing it, and yeah, nothing came. Same thing for Streamliner, where we're still waiting for an update. So let's go through these updates now that we remind ourselves what Metric AB actually is and that it's a pretty useful tool, checking, you know, stereo image, dynamics, loudness, and all of these things. So, well, first of all, my favorite, new feature is always this with Plugin Alliance plugins. The older ones are just so tiny, small. Imagine a plugin looking like this. It's great, but on a big screen, it's just too small. So they gave us these resizing options. All right, there are a lot of new features. First of all, M1, M2, Ventura, and all that good stuff, compatibility. One of the things that sticks out to me is that we have now a plugin delay compensation. All right, so the PDC allows us to listen to both A and the B stream. And so here we have the same track again loaded, which you already know. And so if I play this back and listen to A and B mixed together, you can see that there's quite a big of a delay here. And so why is this important? Well, it's important in the sense that when we do an A-B comparison, it would be good to at least be a little bit closer. Also, it would make our meters more correct. So because if we look at the spectrum meter, these things don't happen, as you can see, at the same time. So let's go back to playback and adjust this. Let's see. It's quite a bit. It's like, I don't know, like 250 milliseconds or something. And this is samples. So here we go. All right, so we're going to go a little bit higher here. Still. Right, we're going to go. This should be it right here. Starts to flange, right? That's close enough for me. Here we go. Let's check it out. So now we're gonna switch. It's really smooth now. Let's look at the meters. So if the DAW doesn't correct that properly itself, you can do that here in the playback section. The other feature I really like is now the ability to kind of zoom in where you're comparing things, right? You see this little button here? So if I press... can look at the stereo image exactly for this frequency range, and I can make this larger. So you want to see what it's doing? to between 90 and 2K. Now you compare. And I like how easy that is. Just check the top end.
I know what I was doing,
The other thing that is has been improved is also the level matching. So if I have two tracks that are happening at the same time that I compare, right? In this case, I'm literally comparing the same track, but sometimes you want to compare something that is just similar. You just hit level match and it matches it as best as it can, and it's fairly accurate. Let's take a listen.
Forget it, it ain't yet the seasons. Gave you all the time. You need to know. Gave you the time. You need to know.
The loudness feature has always been a staple that I really appreciated because you can see both sides of, you know, both tracks, and you can analyze them properly, integrated, LUFS, short-term, momentary, loudness range, true peak, RMS. Here, of course, this section here is after you've level matched it. So if we go back here and leave the track as it is, then what you will see here is quite some difference, right? Because we are applying a limiter, and we're applying a little bit of saturation, and then we're cutting a little bit around the sides and things like that. So that just allows everything to become a little bit louder. This is a good update, and a quick run through here. The other thing, this is pretty cool, this minimized version where you can just go by listening to things, what you're doing to your audio, by comparing. This is pretty cool. This one sets all instances, all reference tracks that you might have loaded up here, right, to the same level. So you can compare to other tracks that you all like, that you want to compare yourself to, and then just level match through this here. And here we have a number of options how we can set things up. Just one thing, plugin alliance, please keep updating your plugins. Don't sell upgrades, keep updating plugins with compatibility, number one, and also with, you know, a lot of them need that resizable GUI, the Elysia Alpha compressor. A lot of plugins are just stuck, you know, even that are not even that old, not resizable, look like abandonware to me. Please do these things fast. Whenever I email, I'm hearing that it's in the works. But seriously, maybe instead of releasing a new plugin every couple of weeks, just fix the ones that you already have, which is what Metric AB just received. This is, of course, goes to the credit of Adapter Audio. Overall, keep your stuff updated. That's just good customer service, and we will thank you for it. But yeah, here's one for the books.